Hallelujah. She is a dependable prayer warrior. My God, when you need to be prayed for, you just call upon Minister Roxann and she jumps on in. Mighty God of Zion, she prays the power down and she is dependable, reliable, and she's committed to the call. And so this morning, I know that God is going to show up and show out. Hallelujah. Today, because the Lord has given her a word for just a time as this. And Lord, I thank you. I pray that you'll jump into Minister Roxann this morning, Father. Hallelujah. Her vessel is ripe and it's available to you. So this morning, have your way in Minister Roxann Small. So Facebook, Zoom, wherever you're logging in this morning, receive this incredible woman of God. Hallelujah, that I call my sister, my right hand, my armor bearer. She's in Connecticut, and I tell you, it doesn't matter time or space. She is there whenever I need her. So this morning, please receive the amazing Minister Roxann Small. God bless you, everybody.
Shall we bless the Lord? Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor Carleen. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised and he's worthy to be exalted. Just open up your mic and shout hallelujah, man. Thank you, Jesus. You have been so good to us. God has been so good to us. The devil thought he killed us last night, but he should have checked our pulse this morning. We are alive and well. We are up. We have so much to thank him for this morning. Maybe we don't have the surplus, but we have enough. Hallelujah. Even to have life, even to wake up. We're not in a wheelchair. We're not on the ventilator.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
We're on our own this morning. We wake up. When you think about the persons in the hospital, maybe somebody have to be changing them now. But we have so much to give God thanks this morning. And we are going to praise him in the good time. And we are going to praise him in the bad time. God is awesome. He's awesome. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Carlin, for the prayer. I was so nervous, but God is good all the time. I ask God more of you, Lord, and less of me this morning. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Father God, as I come in your presence this morning, I just want to thank you for everything that you have done for me. Mighty God, forgive me for everything that I've said and done wrong. It's a wisdom I know not. Mighty God, I bind every strong man, principalities and powers, darkness, rulers of this earth. You cannot enter the strong man house unless you bind him. And mighty God, I bind him in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, let the service be free. Mighty God, speak through me, mighty God. Ask him for a double portion of anointing, mighty God. As I'm about to speak about the men, mighty God. Mighty God, I ask him to rise up all the men that are sleeping, mighty God, to their spiritual calling this morning, mighty God. Touch Pastor Mark, mighty God, all the men that are on board, mighty God. Brother Mervin, Brother Carl, mighty God. God, cover them on your blood, mighty God. We're asking the men to take their rightful position and lead, mighty God, because you call them to lead. Mighty God, I give you thanks. I give you praise. Go before me, mighty God, and do thy work thyself. In your name I pray, amen and amen. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised and he's worthy to be worshiped this morning. My topic this morning is taken from Genesis 2, 21 to 24. Hallelujah. I'm going to read the scripture. Hallelujah. Amen. And the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam. And he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman and brought her unto man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman because she was taken out of the man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Hallelujah. As we read in the scripture earlier, we see about Adam and Eve. Adam, morning, Lord put Adam to sleep. Clearly that Adam was here before Eve. And that even though he put Adam to sleep, he wake up Adam. Adam was awoke. He wake him up. He's not still asleep. He's up. So now that means what I'm trying to tell you, that The topic this morning is waking up all men to their spiritual calling. That God made the man first. That the man is always a leader and supposed to be the leader. Nowadays, we hardly have leaders in church as men. So, Adam, nowadays it seems like verse 21, 25, we're talking about waking up all the men to their spiritual calling. Men, you are born to lead. Men, you are leaders. Wake up to your spiritual calling. Even in the church, no, we mostly have ladies. Where are the men to lead? We need more Christian brothers. We need more Christian fathers for the young generation to look up to. Even though we read in the scripture that God put Adam to sleep, the same scripture told you that he woke him up. So why are some men still sleeping? We need the men to rise up. We need the men to come. We need the men to lead because you're called to lead. 1 Corinthians 16 verse 13 say, be watchful. We're talking about the men. Be watchful. Stand firm in the faith. Act like men and be strong men. Act like men and be strong men. Act like a man, do what you're supposed to do. Take up your responsibility. You're supposed to lead. We have too many single mothers out there struggling without father for their children. They don't know what to do. Men, just lead. You're called to lead. And I'm calling you out this morning to your spiritual calling. We need encouragement, godly wisdom. And hope today more than never. Men need encouragement. Men need godly wisdom and hope today for more than ever. We need to start praying for our men. While the world tends to tell men to hide their emotion and act tough, God's word is filled with men who passionately and wholeheartedly sought God with their heart, mind, and soul. God has a special calling for men to be strong, courageous leaders, and his scripture can provide the inspiration that you need to take daily steps towards your calling. Men, just read the Bible. The Bible is like a GPS to heaven for me. Whatever you want to know, just read the Bible. Sometimes you're going through some tough time. Sometimes you're going through some rough time. But turn to the Bible. Go down on your knee and cry to Jesus. Turn to the Bible. I know it's not easy, but you are called to lead. Come out in a purpose, because purpose can never die. God has a special calling for you. Men, don't be afraid to cry, because expressive men become a good husband and leaders. I'll repeat that again. Men, don't be afraid to cry, because expressive men become good husband and leaders. Even in the Bible, it tells you that Jesus wept. Even David, with a big heart, cried when his son died. I remember when I was much smaller, if a little boy fall or something, and you cry, they say, get up, man up, and stop crying. Are you a girl? I think those things hold on the man. They think they should be tough, even when you're going through pain. They don't want to cry. They don't want to express their feeling because of what people are going to say. But men, don't be afraid to cry, because expressive men become good husband and leaders. And we're looking for some good Christian husband. We're looking for some leaders. We need positive leaders for our young youth, for this young generation nowadays. So men, I'm calling you up this morning to your purpose, your spiritual purpose. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised and he's worthy to be exalted. So when you have a problem where you don't want to tell anyone, find a quiet spot and cry out to the Lord for help. Cry out, help, help. Lord, I need you now. I tried everything and everything has failed me. But Lord, I need you now. He said, tears are like language. God understands. God sees those tears of the broken heart and soul. God sees those tears and he hears them when you fall. God walks along with men. And he takes them by the hand. So tears are like language. God understands. Even if you don't want to cry in front of your children, in front of your wife for them to call you baby, and yourself like porridge or soft like potato when it cook, just go and cry to God. Just take it to the Lord in prayer. One thing for certain, God answer prayer. So I'm calling out the men this morning to their spiritual calling. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised and he's worthy to be exalted. We're praying for the men this morning, no matter what they're going through. We're praying for them this morning. God is able. God is able. God is able this morning. God is able this morning. Hallelujah. So no matter what you're going through, men, just cry out. No matter what people are going to say about you, all the men, no matter what they're going to talk about you, men, no matter what you're going through today, just stay connected to God. Just stay connected to God. He can turn your mess into a messenger. He can turn your test into a testimony. A lot of men are out there hurting and afraid to express themselves because they're afraid of what people are going to say about them. Who cares? Men, I know the struggle is real, but don't give up. Don't give in. Just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm. I'm here this morning to call out the men to their spiritual calling. Men are called to lead in the name of Jesus. Speak life in every dead situation, man, you have today. Speak life. Speak life. You need to understand that the blood of Jesus still works. Many of us men, we grew up in churches, even when we are not going, our parents are not going to church. They're sending us to church. That's why sometimes when I see some people come to America, it's like, they always say, yeah, that song that no foreign God can take my place. No matter if, my mother used to send me, if it's Saturday, she's sending me with the Adventist them. If it's Sunday, she's sending me. She young, and those times she was going to church, she only wanted to see somebody wait for her and have to be going down there with them. We all grew up in church as Jamaicans. Our mother grows up in church. We all grew up in church. God is good all the time. God is good and he's worthy to be praised. So men, speak life, man. Speak life. You need to understand that the blood of Jesus still works. Psalms 51, 10 verse and verse 12 say, creating me a clean heart, Lord. Even though you know you do some things, say, Lord, forgive me. I went wrong. But this morning, Lord, I'm asking to create in me a clean heart, God, and renew the right spirit within me. Cast me not away from the presence, O Lord, and take not thy Holy Spirit within me, but renew unto me the joy of my salvation. Men, cry out to God, your leaders. Lead. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 said, I know the plans I have for you, declare the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and future. The Bible says, young man, I call on you because you are strong. We need some more youths in the church. Too many young men out in the world and the devil trying to kill them in sin. The devil only come to kill, steal, and destroy. But God come to give your life and life more abundantly. Men, when you're in trouble, your friends can't help you. Your mother can't help you. Your father can't help you. Just focus on Jesus. Hell is real, just as all heaven is real. Let us not do anything to go to hell. Let us reach out and touch the Lord as he passes by. We need more men in the church. We need more men in the church. So I'm encouraging the men this morning. Rise up, man. Rise up this morning. Rise up. Rise up. Rise up. The Adams are sleeping. Rise up. God put Adam to sleep. Adam, wake up. God put Adam to sleep, but he wake him up. Seems like the men are sleeping. Men, wake up to your rightful position. We need the men. Wake up. God is here, the man. God is here, but wake up no matter what you're going through. No matter what you're going through. As I said before, the devil only come to kill, steal,
and destroy. But God come to give you a life more abundantly. Mothers, let us pray for our sons. Mothers, let us pray for our son. Cover them under the blood of Jesus. Cover their going out and their coming in. The young men are under peer pressure. They're crying out for help. You send your good Christian son to school. They come back home acting up and want to, they don't want to go back to church. They start smoking and drinking. Let us cry out for our sons. Let us cry out for our brothers. Let us cry out for our fathers. Let us cry out for our uncles who is still in the rum bar and the gambling house. Some people, they rather walk with a stick. I know a man in my community. Listen me, I when he's sick, he might go buy cash back. Him no care. They're still smoking the ganja. They're doing stuff that they're not supposed to do. Let us pray for them. Let us call them out. Let us pray for them, man. Let us cry out for them, man. Let us cry for our uncles, man. Let us cry out for them, man. They need our help. They need our prayers. Remember, we were out in sin and somebody cried out for us. Too many young men going to prison. Too many young men dying. Lord, I ask for mercy for them this morning. Save them, mighty God. Save them, mighty God. Save them. You're here today, you're gone tomorrow. The songwriter said, one day at a time, sweet Jesus. No matter what you're going through and the struggle, say, Lord, one day at a time, sweet Jesus. That is all I'm asking of you, mighty God. Give me the strength. I am weak to do everything that I have to do. Mighty God, yesterday gone, sweet Jesus. And tomorrow may never be mine. But Lord, for my sake, teach me to take, Lord, one day at a time. Lord, men, cry out to Jesus this morning. Cry out to him. Here today, you're gone tomorrow. Sometimes you're here talking to some people, you don't know who they're down the road. Oh, but I just talked to that person. Nobody know the minute nor the hour. We need to cry out for the men. They are called to be leaders. Ladies, we need to cry out for our unsaved husband. We need to call them to the calling. They are called to lead, not us. Most of you see some of the young men, they just kneel in their hand. And what the ladies out there doing construction work. And the fathers are doing nothing but sit there with their pants down below and they are kneeling and their color change. And God, we need back our men. We need them back. We need back our men. We're claiming them for the spiritual calling. Because you call man to lead. You never call us to lead. And sometimes when I hear people say, you must have a female preacher. If we never did a preach, what would happen? We have to take a stand and call them back in. We have to take a stand and call back the men. We have to take a stand and call in back the men. Mothers, let us pray for our son, man. And cover them under the blood, man. Just cover them under your blood. Just cover them under your blood. Let us pray for our uncle and everybody. Everybody, let us just pray for them, man. Praying for the mothers. Let us pray for them. Let us pray for them, God. God, I'm asking you for the strength for the men who are weak. For the men who are there suffering. For the men who are crying out for help. We're crying out for our prayers. Some of us Christians, we need to go and even say to them, say, God love you. They just only need a word. They just only need a word. Because sometimes some people say something to them and condemn them. There's a power lies in the tongue. So we're just going to pray for them. If you have an unsaved husband, just pray for him. Not criticize him. And if you're a Christian, Romans 8 verse 1 said, therefore there's no condemnation in them that is Christ, in Christ Jesus, who walk after the flesh. And we walk after the spirit. So when you see the husband in sin, they're doing the fleshy things. They can never do better because you're walking after the flesh. So when people walking after the flesh, you expect them to do fleshy thing. So we as Christians, the Christian's wife, we're walking after the spirit. Our spiritual duty is to pray for our husband. Because we say we're wrestling not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and power. We are not wrestling against our husband. We're wrestling against a spiritual warfare that come up against them. So we're going to take a stand as wife. A, we know sometimes we can't take them, we can't bother with. I don't ever like see you. But our all art and duty is to pray for them. We are stronger than them. Let us pray for them. Let us just pray for them. Let us just pray for them. Men need our prayers. Today, here today, they gone tomorrow. I think from last month or last couple, 5 couple days until now, I know 5 persons or more that I know well that died in Jamaica. Men, I'm telling you about the men. We're talking about the men. So you're not too young today. You're not too old today. You're not too nice today. You're not too handsome today. When they come, you gotta go. And when I think about those guys that died, we're praying for those mothers. I have an incident in my city right here in Waterbury. The son was coming from court with his mother. And somebody come up and shot him straight in front of his mother. Kill him right there in front of his mother. I just imagine that mother pain. Mothers, just imagine if it was you, no matter how bad your children is, no matter how bad them is, you're praying for them. No matter how other people out on the street talking bad about them, is your child, is your belly pain. When they get in trouble, you feel that shift in your womb. You feel every pain, every contraction. And I just imagine that mother see your child get shot in front of you, right in front of you. Let us pray for our mothers and our sons. I have another incident back home when I'm a friend who died. Eat that guy, no matter what. The different party, because we have different party, but when you're friends, you're friends. And that mother, she had a son die here in America. And she was waiting for her son to take her to the airport to come bury her son in America. She didn't see her son turn up. She never see her son turn up. We got to pray for all these mothers. We got to pray for all these mothers. We got to pray for them. Pray for the mothers who lose their son, man. Their young man, their young people, man. Let us pray for them, man. Let us pray for them. Let us keep the mothers in our prayers, man. When she was waiting for her son to take her to the airport, not hearing from him, the call she got was disturbing and heartbroken. Remember, she coming to America to bury her son, and she waiting on the next son to take her to the airport to come to America. And when she hear a call, the son that she waiting on to take her to America die, drop down and dead. That is heartbroken. She had 2 sons died in a week. How can I feel? How about the mother's pain this morning? I'm crying out for that mother. I just imagine what she's going through. You're about to bury one of your sons in America. And you're waiting on the next son to bring her to the airport. And when you're waiting on your son, you cannot hear your son dropped down and dead. We are crying for young men. We are calling them to God. As I said before, only thing the devil come to do, kill, steal, and destroy. All the devil come to do is give a one day pleasure. Nothing more. Nothing more but a one day pleasure and a one time pleasure. And that's it. I watched something on Facebook with this young man. He was there. It's like they show him hell and heaven. Heaven was so boring to him. That's what he said. He don't want to stay there. When he go over hell, he say, holy put nice things. And the man say, what do you want, hell or heaven? He say, hell. And when he go over there, he say, everything. But the next day, the devil call him back. And carry him into hell. And he say, what am I doing here? This is not what I see yesterday. He say, yesterday I was recruiting. And you vote. So that's why you are here. Let us vote for Jesus. Let us vote for heaven. Hell is real. Hell is real. So even though son that died, Lord, let us keep that mother in your prayer. Let us keep watch over. Let's keep that mother and family in your prayers. Let us pray for family and friends who are out there in sin. Let us not sin in church as if we are holy than everyone and watching our family go into hell. Somehow we are going to shame. Pray for our family. You're watching because you're all this and that. You're in church. And your family out there dying. Your brothers out there dying. Your sisters out there dying. Your nieces and your nephews dying. Young man, I call on you because you are strong. Lord, I'm crying out for all the men in my family who are not saved. The Christian husband, I'm encouraging you this morning. Stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ has set you free and be not entangled in the yoke of bondage again. Husband are called to lead. Husband, you are supposed to be leading your family into the presence of God. Husband, love your wife. Joshua said, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, not me alone. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. The devil is cunning. I am a minister. And my children, my son, he used to preach. He used to moderate a church. And the devil rob him. But you see, as a mother, listen, my man, train up a child, he will not depart for that. Him have to come back. If I even fast enough, him have to come back. The day I said to him, say, you see, you have to come back. He said, I'm wishing bad for him. I said, no. I said, you have to come back. I will, you have to come back. I'm not even looking at you over there. Because you must come back. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. One Sunday, I remember, I decided he's not coming to church. I'm going to lock him out. You're not coming to church. You're not staying in my house. I lock him out. I'm going to wake him out and sleep and lock him out. And the rain will fall outside and he's hungry. And my call me, I said, don't call me. I'm at church. And I'm not cruel. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Men, just stay connected to the true vine, man. Stay connected to the true vine. St. John 15, verse 5 say, I am the true vine. Ye are the branches. He that abide in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, he can do nothing. Men, without Christ, we are nothing. Praying for all the men near and far to repent. Before it's too late. Men, repent before it's too late. Repent before it's too late. Without Jesus, we are nothing. I remember another story when Jesus was going through. And when he was going through with the two donkeys and the colt, and he was going through. We know, we all know that scripture. And when they dropped down thing and called Hosanna, everybody, and he was going on the donkey, everybody praised him. The next day, because Jesus was there, the next day, the two donkeys going through. And the next one said to them, yesterday, I was here. And everybody was praising me when Jesus was here. The other donkey turned to him and said, without Jesus, you are nothing. They praised him yesterday because Jesus was there. So men, without Jesus, we are nothing. If you died where the tree fall, there shall it lie until the day of judgment. Men, we are calling in your purpose. Men, we're calling to lead the young youths. We're calling to repent before it's too late. On the funeral program, who know about funeral program? Because we love to go to funeral and even fight for program. I went to a funeral and people almost pushed me down for the program. I don't know why. I don't know what about the program. But we all know the funeral program. And on it, we see the day when the person born. And the dash in between. And the day when the person die. The dash is how you live your life between birth and death. That's the dash between. It's when you're born and how you live your life and the death. Let the life you live speak for your men. Men, how are you living your dash today? Men, are you living your dash in the gambling house? Are you living your dash in the rum bar? Are you living your dash with the gun? How are you living your dash today? Your dash is to serve God. Your dash is to serve God. Your dash is to worship God. Be careful how you live your dash. Hell is real. And heaven is also real. Men two road before you pick your choice. Put down the gun. God is able. He's a way maker no matter what you're going through. He's a miracle worker. He's a promise keeper. He's a light in the darkness. My God, that is who he is this morning. He's the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He can do all things but fail, and he never lost a battle. When he's 40 late, he's always on time. He's the same God, man. He's the same God that give you 24 hours and give me. He's the same God. And he can do all things but fail, man. He's the God of the mountain. He's the God in the valley. He's still God. When things are right, when things are wrong, he's still God. Yahweh, come and do what no one else can do for the men this morning. I say, Yahweh, come and do what no one else can do for the men this morning. Hold on to Jesus. He'll do it again. Hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm, men. I know the struggle is real, you know. The struggle is real. But hold on to Jesus. Down on your knee, just talk to Jesus. Hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm this morning. You may not know how. You may not know when, but he'll do it again. He's still God. He has not changed. He's still God. And he's fighting for you this morning, men. He's fighting for you this morning. He has not changed. Whatever the situation, whatever the problem, there's no problem. There's no prayer that never answer. Only because our time is not God's time. Lazarus was in the grave and he died 4 days. Even the sister says, stink it by now. But even when your situation is stinking, God can come and heal you. Even when you're done and talking to the men on the Zoom, on the Facebook, Instagram, wherever you are, listen, God will not give up on you. Stop giving up on yourself. Maybe you don't have a job now, but God will provide. Just turn to Jesus. Find a church. Find somewhere to fellowship. Maybe you don't have food on your table. He's a provider. He's a way maker. So I'm calling out all the men to their spiritual calling. You're called to lead. You're called to be in the church. You're called to be an example to the next generation. And I'm praying for all the men that turn their back, that people turn their back on, that people say bad things about, that people talk bad things about, and said they're coming out to nothing. We're crying out for them this morning. Let us stop condemning each other. Let us stop talking bad about people. We were out there in sin and somebody prayed for us. He's still God. Even the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years, no matter how long your situation is, God will come true for you. No matter how bad it look, God will come true for you. Man, I'm calling you out this morning to your spiritual calling. We are calling you out this morning. You are called to your spiritual calling. Man, I'm calling you out this morning. We're calling out the men this morning. God is able, man. Sometimes when you look in the schools nowadays for the young boys going to school, it's a shame to how they behave. They're fighting teachers. They're doing stuff. The devil trying to take charge of the young people. The devil trying to take over the young people. And when they do bad, let us just pray for them. Let us not criticize them. Let us just don't let them down. It's like you get a wound and somebody just beat you in the wound. It's not easy. Don't let another wounded soldier die, man. Let us pray for the men. Ladies, you don't think we're tired? Anything, we're up front. Thank God for the Christian men. Thank God for them. Sometimes most of the pressure on the ladies because we're trying to lead. We lead the house. We do everything in the house as if we're the man. Men, we are calling you out, man. Take up a rightful position. And we're not telling about taking up the position, being in a gang leader, being in a bad man, doing stuff that you're not supposed to do. Take up your calling, your spirit as a spiritual leader to come and lead in a church for the next generation. I cover all the men under the blood of Jesus this morning. And every plan that the enemy have to shut them down, I come up against it in the name of Jesus. Even the one who has the cocaine and the needle to shoot up himself to become a zombie after. I pray God give them strength. Sometimes when I look on my street, I say, Jesus, zombies, I look at zombies. They do some stuff when they take the coat. They don't know what to do. All I can say, Lord, pray for them. Have mercy upon them. Have mercy upon them, Jesus. Sometimes you don't know what they're going through. You don't know what they're going through. Even the gays, let us pray for them to come back. You don't know what happened to them when they are small. You don't know who molested them. So let us pray for our babies. I have one grandson. And my daughter-in-law tell me one time, say, listen me, I see him with some friend. I said, why is he beside those guys? She trusts him. I said, listen me, not me. You trust him, not me. You don't know what happened when your babies are small. And be careful who you leave your children with. Be careful who you leave your young babies with. Let us be careful. You turn them into stuff that they are not supposed to be. When they look a nice, nice son, when him a go to makeup cooler than your one, him ear flashy than your one, be careful who you left your children with when they're young. God made Adam and Eve. Let us call out our men, them. Let us call them out and pray for them. Let us stop criticizing them, power lies in the tongue. The more you see them going on, and you're still bringing them down. What type of Christian are we? God save us. He said, go out on the byway, highway, and edges and pray for them. Call them back in. That's our responsibility this morning. And as I said this morning, I am crying out and calling out for the men. There are so many young ladies in church, single by themselves for much years. When you check in the church nowadays, if you find, for example, if you find 20 ladies, just your finger, this can't count the five fingers, then you're not finished with men. So we need more men. There are a lot of husbands out there that they're never trying to kill. Let us bring them in, man. Let us pray for them. I spoke to a guy the other day. I was coming and one of my friends said he need prayer and he recommend me to pray for him. He's in Jamaica. And when I heard that guy talk, the guy said, listen, man, although me living in this town, you know, at Jamaica, you know, nothing good not come out here. So, but it's not everybody in here bad. That moved me when I heard that young man say that. And I don't pray for him as yet. I move by the leading of the Holy Spirit. The little youth was telling the guy, it's not everybody in here bad. And everybody look on us as bad person and write us off. And I said, wow, that little youth cried. All he was asking the guy to just get some people, just pray for me. Just prayer. The youths are crying out for us to pray for them. They're out there crying. They need our help. Let us open our spiritual eyes and see that our husbands are going down. Let us open our spiritual eyes and look at our sons. Let us look and open our spiritual eyes, our father, daughters. Come on, some of us daughters become son now. Everybody going their own way. The world is just turning, 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 and turning the wrong way. But let us look up and pray for them. Embrace them. Even today, if you know somebody is going out of the way, just even write down their name and call them name to Jesus. Even if you don't have a son, call somebody's son out name. You must have an uncle. I have two brothers who are not saved. And I'm not going to stop until they're saved. My son-in-law is not saved. and I'm going to pray for him. My two son, not saved. The big one, he more act like him saved, but the little one, I'm going on in sackcloth and ashes for him. I tell him, say, even if you use up a drum of consecrated olive oil, you're coming back. I am not going to be here ministering to people and my children are going to hell. No. And my brothers and sisters are going to hell. No. Evangelist Foot and I are the only. We are the two. We are three sisters and the two of us are saved. And we have another little sister. We are not going to stop praying for them until they come to Jesus. Whatever it takes, they got to come. They got to come. Yeah, some grandfathers, they can't hardly walk. And the words that come out of their mouth. Let us pray for them, man. Let us pray for them. Even if they see that they're dying, they don't care. They don't see. Because they're walking in the flesh, so they do fleshy things. It's not condemning them. We're in the spirit. Let us do the spiritual stuff. Let us pray them up and ask God to cover them. Ask God to cover them. He said, upon this rock I build my church. And let us say the gates of hell shall not prevail against the men. We decree and we declare blessing upon the men's life. We decree and we declare turn around. We decree and we declare double portion of anointing. We decree and we declare men to take their rightful position in the church and lead. We decree and we declare everything that God has for them this morning, whether you are near or far. And we just want to thank God for the husbands, the spiritual husband who are more of God, who want to lead their family, who want to lead their wives, who want to take charge and come up front. We thank God for those spiritual husbands. We thank God for the Christians' husband. Mighty God, cover them on your blood. It's not easy for them. It's not easy. But I pray for coverage for them this morning. Father God, as they come in your presence this morning, I just want to thank you for this word. I just want to thank you for what you have done and what you're about to do. Mighty God, I am calling out all the men this morning, mighty God. You know wherever they are, mighty God, the pain they're going through, the hurt they're going through, mighty God. Mighty God, let them go down in sackcloth and ashes. Let them cry out for you this morning, God. Let them cry out, mighty God. They can't hold it out no longer. Whatever the situation, mighty God, if it's some sign you gotta show them for them to come out, if it's some sign you gotta show them for them to rise to their spiritual calling this morning, mighty God, I cry out for them this morning. Mighty God, I cry out for them, mighty God. Mighty God, let your grace and mercy follow them, mighty God. Let them know morning by morning new mercies you have showed them. And mighty God, I cover them under the blood. No weapon formed against them shall prosper. In the name of Jesus, I cry out for the unsaved husband. I cry for the unsaved son. I cry for the unsaved uncle. I cry out for the unsaved nephew. I calling them out, mighty God. Let the devil know, no, only come to kill, steal, and destroy. But mighty God, you give them life. Mighty God, let them try you one more time, mighty God. Let them give you a chance in their life. So no matter what they're going through, mighty God, I cry out for them this morning. I cry out for them. No weapon formed against them shall prosper, mighty God. And everybody who tried to put up against them, everybody who tried to talk bad against them, mighty God, cover them on your blood, Jesus. I cover them on your blood, mighty God. I cover them, mighty God. I know the struggle is real. I know it's rough, but mighty God, let them turn to you. You say, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all his righteousness shall be added after. Let them know after you seek, they seek your God. You will provide for them. You will make a way for them, mighty God. Mighty God, teach them to humble themselves this morning. Teach them to humble themselves. Teach them to humble themselves, mighty God. The Bible said, those that exalt themselves shall be abased, but those who humble themselves shall be exalted. Teach them to be humble this morning, Jesus. Search your life. See if there be anything wrong that don't belong. Lord, take it out of them, mighty God. They want to be more than an ordinary servant, mighty God. They just need someone to say a word to them. They just need someone to touch them. They just need someone to encourage them, mighty God. Teach them to speak over their self and encourage yourself, mighty God. We encourage them this morning, mighty God. At this word, God, mighty God, I call in all the men to their spiritual calling. Father God, the men are called to lead, and we're calling them out, mighty God. Let them know that we appreciate them. Let them know that we love them. Let them know that we care for them. God put Adam to sleep, but he wake him up. We're waking up all the sleeping men this morning to their spiritual calling. And mighty God, I tell you thanks for what you have done and what you are about to do, mighty God. I thank you for Pastor Carly. I thank each and every person on the Zoom, one the other platform. Listen, mighty God. I hope this word go to the men and it touch them, mighty God. Let them know that we don't condemn them, mighty God. I pray for Pastor Mark as a leader. Give him strength, mighty God, to stand up beside his wife, mighty God. We need more husbands and people to stand up, mighty God. I give you thanks, mighty God. I give you praise. I pray for Brother Carl, mighty God. Cover him under your blood. Give him a double portion of anointing this morning, mighty God. Mighty God, touch us again, mighty God. This moment we need of a fresh touch from thee. Give the men a fresh touch this morning. Mighty God, I tell you thanks. I seal my prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. I now hand over back to Pastor Carlene. God is able. Amen.
Amen. God is able. God is able. What a word. This morning, calling all men to your spiritual calling, meaning wake up all the sleeping Adams. Adam, this morning, wake up. We are calling you back to your rightful place. There's a part in the sermon that I love so much. It was yesterday I was recruiting. Today's the real deal. You know, the devil is recruiting hard, and it seems so nice. It's what you want. But there's coming tomorrow where it's the real deal. Remember during recruiting day, the carpet is rolled out for you. The red carpet, it's well spread. The food looks good. Everything looks appealing. But there's a tomorrow that's coming when the real deal step in. Don't let the devil rob you of what God has for you. Because the Lord says that I come that I might have, that you might have life, and have it more abundantly. God comes to give life, but the devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, for I know the plan I have for you, declares the Lord. Plan for welfare, meaning to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you a future and a hope. Men, amen. God has a plan for you, and we're calling you back. We women want to take the back seat. We do. But yes, there's so much at stake. There is too much at stake. And when you're not rising up, we've got to get up.
Got to rise.
Do we want to? I'm telling you, no, I don't want to. But you know what? Too much is at stake. Too much is at stake. So we're sending out the clarion call this morning. Come back to your rightful place. The church is too scanty without you. We love to see our sisters there. Of course we do. But we want to see the men there. So rise up and take your rightful place. And today we're going to pray for you. We are interceding for you. We're not casting judgment upon you, but we're praying for you that you find your way back, that the prodigal sons return home, because a father has his arms outstretched and saying, welcome home, my son. Come on in. And so this morning, our job is to stay on our knees and to cry out for you. We know it's not easy. We know it's very hard. So we this morning declares the word of the Lord over you. We declare it, we decree it. And when something is declared and decreed, it must manifest. And so this morning the call has been given. And I pray that you say, I yield. I can't run.
I can't hold it no longer.
Can't. So this morning, every son, every brother, every father, every uncle, every cousin, every
Jesus.
Friend, we call you back
this morning.
Fold. We are in need of you.
Jesus.
We can't do this without
you.
We want you beside us. We want you in front of us leading the way. We need you. But this morning, we cry out for you.
Jesus.
So Father, as we cry out, I pray this morning that you dispatch your angels to go and get them. Hallelujah. We pray this morning, Lord God, that every wayward son, every wayward father, every wayward brother, hallelujah.
Jesus.
I pray this morning that you go and get them. Every man that is feeling lonely and depressed and wounded this morning, we won't let a wounded soldier die this morning. Father, this morning, I pray that every word that's spoken, Lord God, will apprehend them. Every tear that is cried, Lord God Almighty, every pillow that's been wet, Father, crying out for that son, that father, Lord God, this morning, that brother, oh God, this morning, I pray that the words, oh God, this morning, Father, apprehend them. I pray that that cry, Lord God, apprehend them this morning in the mighty name of Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
Father, we won't stop until, hallelujah, they heed to the call, Father God, because the enemy is recruiting, and so are we this morning. And we raise the banner, Lord God Almighty, this morning. We raise the banner, Lord God, this morning. And we know that your banner speaks, hallelujah. We know that we are more than conqueror, hallelujah, Lord God Almighty. We know that we shall be and will be victorious because the battle is already won. And so this morning, Lord God, I pray that this word will reach far and wide, Father. And I pray that that wounded soldier, Lord God, hears this word this morning and something hits their heart, Father, and they will yield to your word. Father, we thank you for what you are doing and what you are about to do. And we receive it and we claim it in your mighty name, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the blessed Holy Ghost. I pray this morning that if you're in need of prayer, despite the fact that we're virtual, it is no secret what God
what
can
God can do.
But he's done for others.
He'll
he
do it for you.
For you. It doesn't matter if you're shooting up, if you're drinking, if you're smoking, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Because I know that the blood of Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, still speaks. And the blood reaches, hallelujah, this morning.
Hallelujah.
No matter where you are, the blood
reaches.
No matter how vile you are this morning, the blood cleanses and it will wash your sin
hallelujah.
Away. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what you
hallelujah.
Have done. The blood cries Jesus. Out for you this morning. It doesn't matter if you're rising up this morning out Jesus. Of the dungeon. The blood still peaks, and it will wipe you and wash you white as snow. Glory, hallelujah. And the Lord is calling you out. Oh, the sleeping Adam, he's calling you to arise. Because you know what? When Adam sinned, it wasn't Adam that went looking for the Lord, but the Lord came looking for him. The Bible says, look, God said, Adam, where art thou?
Mm-hmm.
Where art thou? And this morning, we're saying the same thing.
Adam.
Adam, where art thou?
Mm.
Where art thou, Adam?
Adam, hiding.
Mm. Come back. Come back.
Mm.
Come back. Because our God will shield you. He'll protect you. He will give you a new name. Mm. He will give you a new name. Hallelujah. He will wipe your slate clean. He'll put your sin into the sea of forgetfulness. It doesn't matter what you have done, but he'll wipe it all away. And this morning, it's extended unto you. Will you come?
One more chance.
Like the story that was told. Yes, heaven looked boring.
Mm-hmm.
But it looked exciting. But remember, it's
recruiting day.
It's recruiting day.
And
so everything looks good. on recruiting day. Everything looks good on recruiting day, but tomorrow is coming. Remember that.
You vote.
Mm. And when you cast your vote, it's final. It's final. So would you cast your vote today for Jesus and make your election sure? Because he's calling you back home. May God bless and keep you again. Drop your name in the chat. Send me a message because we're here to pray for you. It doesn't matter what you have done. Our Father is calling you back home because there is a need of you. Doesn't matter, Adam. We have need for you. So come on back home. Praise God. I want to thank all my speakers so far. Evangelist Alderine Foote last week, and today's minister, Roxann, blazing out of Connecticut. Amen. And next week, we're going to the beautiful island of St. Lucia. Amen. And it's a minister that's on fire, and I can't wait to hear him. Amen. Hallelujah. And then we're going to blaze into the UK to round us out for the month of April. So we just want to thank you all for taking up the call, for taking the charge. Amen. Because our God is doing an awesome thing. Amen. And any vessel that's available, our Lord will inhabit all vessels that are willing and able, and he will lead us all the way. May God bless and keep you on Facebook, and may his face shine upon you. And if you're in need of prayer, wherever this word is deposited, please drop me a line, because we're here to pray for you, calling all men to your spiritual calling, waking up all Adam this morning. Come back to the Lord. Come back. Amen. God bless you, everybody.